Hey there, Michael Church with crawlspaceninja.com. And today we got a question from one of our YouTube watchers that asked us, how do you address radon in a crawl space when the crawl space vents are closed? So stay tuned for the answer. Okay, so just so you know, not all parts of the country have radon issues, but there are several areas that have really bad radon issues, like in the mountains of Colorado and even up in Maine. And the other thing I want to tell you about is all the states, especially the really strict states, have their own radon mitigation protocol. So you want to check with your local and state codes department to find out exactly how to do it their way, because what I'm going to tell you is how we do it here, which may be less strict or more strict than what they're going to tell you to do. Okay, so if you've installed a crawl space encapsulation system, or if you just decided to seal up all the vents in the crawl space and stick a dehu in or whatever, I'm going to give you some tips or at least the explanation of what you should do, whether you need to hire somebody to do it or you could do it yourself. But first of all, I want to point out that most vented crawl spaces, so in other words, if you got a crawl space that all the vents are open all the time, you're probably not going to have a radon issue down there because the vents are open. They're allowing air to transfer back and forth to the outside. So, you know, especially most vented crawl spaces have some kind of fan, so you're moving air around, circulating air. Still really humid and damp and moldy and all that in there, but at least there's not a radon issue. So what a lot of companies will do is they'll encapsulate a crawl space, so they'll go to a dry crawl space with less mold or no mold if they did the mold remediation correctly, but then they can create a radon problem because they've just eliminated the source or the ability for that radon to escape. So if you've already got that problem, here's a couple things you can do. Number one, according to the EPA, you are allowed to install a vent fan like our PCV1, Lamanco fan or our Whisper fan, and I'll put a link to those down below. You can install a crawl space vent fan. According to the EPA, you need one cubic feet per minute of air for every 50 square foot of crawl space. So both of those fans, one is 110 CFM and the other one's 120 CFM. The smaller one, the Lamanco, will do a 5,500 square foot crawl space. I was just on the phone the other day with a gentleman that asked if we had a 50 CFM fan because his crawl space wasn't as big. Well, no, these fans are kind of hard to, you know, you can't really turn them down. You may find a way to do it if you're like an electrical guy and all that kind of stuff. But for the most part, 110 CFM is not really a lot of air anyway. So the Lamanco fan is fine. Even if you got a 500 square foot crawl space, it should be fine. So that's one way to do it. Just put in a fan, have it blowing out all the time so that you're creating a negative pressure underneath the house and the crawl space and pushing the air outside. The second way to do it, so let's say you went and had a radon test. So you're trying to sell your house. They found it was like 28 picocuries per hour or whatever it's called. You've got to like do something. You can't just put a fan in there because they want a radon mitigation system. Well, what this is a submembrane vapor barrier membrane, submembrane depressurization system, which means that you're probably going to have to cut out or at least cut loose the current vapor barrier, plastic, crawl space plastic, and then run a black corrugated pipe that is vented, that's got holes in it. You snake it throughout the crawl space. Then you take it to a 3 or 4 inch PVC line, and then you put your radon fan on the outside. We don't tell people how to do that kind of stuff. So if you want more information, check on like some of the radon sites if you want. It's pretty easy to do. There's a lot of DIY radon sites out there, but that's what you're gonna need to do. You're gonna need to snake this black hose through there, make sure it's perforated so that air can travel through it. And what that does is it doesn't do anything for the air above the vapor barrier, but it sucks the air out below the vapor barrier and then moves it straight out to the outside. Remember, the vent fan has to be outside the crawl space. You don't wanna put it in the crawl because if for some reason it cuts loose or dislarges, you're actually sucking radon and making a worse problem. Can't be within like 25 feet, I think, of the windows. And then that discharge has to shoot up above the roof line. Okay, so some people find it not so great looking when you got this big white pipe sticking out of your crawl going up the roof of the house. So you can paint the pipe if you feel that's necessary. We've installed quite a few of those systems. But anyway, that's what you'd have to do for a radon mitigation system if your crawl space vents are closed and you've had a test. Most of the time, they're gonna wanna make you install that type of system. I recommend you pay a professional to do it because you're also gonna have to adhere the plastic to the wall. You're gonna have to use polyurethane caulk to do it. They have all these regulations on what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to overlap at least 12 inches, polyurethane caulk it, tape the seams, attach it to the wall with polyurethane. So that way, whenever the radon fan kicks on, it's almost like it sucks the plastic to the ground. All right, so my name is Michael Church with crawlspaceninja.com, and I hope that was helpful. If you want to download our DIY crawlspace encapsulation guide, please check in the description down below, and I hope you make it a happy and blessed day. Thanks for watching.